Mother Nature is the most unpredictable and unforgiving force on Earth. At any point, a whipping tornado, flash flood, or catastrophic earthquake can destroy everything in its path, leaving people helpless to the wrath of her fury. For centuries, seismic activity has played a role in destroying major cities and towns across the world. While we often have some kind of warning, thanks to our modern technology, this doesn't always save us from the devastating effects. Join us in this video as we dive into the disastrous effects that would follow if a city on a large-scale urban area experienced a terrifying 9.2 magnitude earthquake. If you were unaware of just how catastrophic Mother Nature can be, stick around as we show you the genuinely destructive effects of such an event. One that may force you to reconsider moving to the beautiful coastal city. This video will undoubtedly shock you to your core, so let's begin. Quick explanation of mega earthquakes. Earthquakes are continuously happening almost every moment of the day. Nations such as Indonesia, Japan, and several US states, including Alaska and California, will experience various minor events at least a few times per day. The natural occurring seismic activity is powered by a sudden release of stored energy in the Earth's crust, which sends out a large waves. This is the phenomenon you feel as the ground begins moving during the initial stages of the earthquake. While these events are generally related to tectonic nature of the Earth, humans have been known to play a role in the cause of such an event, primarily due to fracking, drilling, and mining. The seismic event is generally ranked by a magnitude in numbers and decimal fractions. For example, a 2.2 earthquake would be rather mild. You may feel a slight jolt or a light bulb may begin to swing. At 4.2, it may feel like a truck, heavy truck, is passing. But at 5.5, this is where it begins to get scary. Dishes and windows could crack and break. Cars would be rocked, and poorly designed buildings would be at risk of being damaged. The size of an earthquake increases by a factor of 10 as the magnitude increases. That means a 6.0 earthquake would feel 10 times stronger than a 5.0, and a 7.0 event would feel 10 times stronger than a 6.0, and so on. But generally speaking, anything above 5 or 5.5 is considered a dangerous event. Scientists have discovered that there's a small pattern concerning the frequency of large earthquakes. A study done in the United Kingdom surmised that an earthquake of around 3.7 will occur once a year, whereas one with a magnitude of 5.6 or larger will only happen every century. But some countries are at more risk due to a certain factor. New Zealand, one such country. The tiny island nation straddles the Pacific and Australian tectonic plates, which are constantly colliding with each other at a high force. This causes one to grind over the other slowly, and eventually, the brittle crust gives way under pressure and an earthquake is released. Due to these factors, New Zealand can expect a 5 to 6 magnitude earthquake almost 30 times per year compared to the United Kingdom, once every century, quite the difference. We've seen some horrible earthquakes in recent years, such as the 6.3 magnitude event that destroyed a vast portion of Christchurch, New Zealand. The event destroyed thousands of structures and killed 185 people. Or the catastrophic and destructive 7.8 magnitude earthquake that struck southern and central Turkey, as well as northern and western Syria on February 6, 2023. It caused extensive damage and tens of thousands of casualties. The earthquake is listed as the deadliest in Turkey since the 1268 Cilicia earthquake and in Syria since the 1822 Aleppo earthquake. It is one of the world's deadliest earthquakes since the 2010 Haiti earthquake. It has been felt in Egypt, Israel, the Palestine Authority, Lebanon, Cyprus, and the Black Sea coast of Turkey. The earthquake was followed by more than 2,100 aftershocks. As of the 14th of February, 2023, over 4,100 deaths have been confirmed. A major winter storm hampered rescue efforts, snow fell on the ruins, and caused temperatures to plummet. The earthquake is estimated to have caused $84.1 billion in damage, making it the fourth costliest earthquake in history. Even with all of our modern technology and the various warnings which can prepare us for an incoming earthquake, it's still a largely unpredictable event that can cause mass destruction. But you may be asking, what would happen if a city was hit with an earthquake that reached a mind-boggling magnitude of 9.2? Well, for one, you best pray that you've never been in an area that experiences this, as this horrifying effects would be beyond comprehension. So what would happen if a 8.9.2 earthquake hit a major city? The effects of such a powerful seismic event would ultimately have a devastating effects on a city or region. The shock waves and tremors would last for around 5 minutes, during which small buildings made poorly of masonry would first begin to shake before crumbling into dust. Large skyscrapers would start to shake, and cracks would begin forming on the foundation pillars and those used by the building for support. Even some of the most modern and earthquake-safe buildings would feel the pressure of such an intense event. Bridges would begin swaying in the air before eventually collapsing in on themselves, and objects as heavy as motor vehicles would be flung into the air as if they were weightless. It would indeed be a terrifying sight. But the initial shockwaves are not even the worst part of it. Such a powerful seismic event. If the earthquake occurred in a coastal city or town, tsunami waves that range in height from 20 to 80 feet would swamp low-lying areas, permanently damaging the coastline. While it may seem obsolete to mention, the aftermath of such an earthquake would seem like something straight out of an apocalyptic movie. But has such an event over a magnitude of 9 ever occurred on land? Unfortunately, yes, and on more than one occasion. While it's hard to fathom the level of destruction that would occur if you ever experienced an earthquake, we do have a few references to which we could compare it with. One would be the horrifying 9.4 to 9.6 seismic event that devastated the Central American nation of Chile. During one afternoon back in 1960, the everyday citizens of this Pacific Coast nation would have been going about their day just like any other when all of a sudden, the unimaginable happened. At approximately 3 p.m., the largest earthquake to ever strike a nation ripped through the country for at least 10 minutes, but to the experience of the seismic activity, it would have felt like a lifetime. Two tectonic plates shifted by over 30 meters, releasing vast volumes of energy. Entire cities were reduced to rubble in moments. The epicenter of the mega earthquake was near the small town of Lumaco, which lies 570 kilometers south of San Diego. Valdivia was the city most greatly affected by the seismic waves. Over 2 million people were left homeless. 3,000 were injured, and over 1,500 people died here alone. The economic damage was estimated at around $550 million, which would equate to over $5 billion in 2023. The tremors caused localized tsunamis that battered the entirety of the Chilean coast, forced waves of every 25 meters to smash into the surrounding landscape. One of the main tsunamis traveled across the Pacific Ocean, devastating Hawaii and Hilo on its way. But the force of this earthquake even resulted in tsunamis as far away as Japan, where 130 were killed during floods. An event we can compare it to. While the United States was only marginally affected by the Great Chilean Earthquake, it suffered an event almost as terrifying. 4 years after the event in Chile, the state of Alaska would be hit with the second most decremental earthquake ever recorded. A 9.2 magnitude somatic event would rip through the state, lasting for over 4 minutes. In the wake of the shockwaves, large parts of central and southern Alaska's infrastructure were completely destroyed. The Capitol building was severely damaged and entire roads were destroyed. Just like the Chile post-quake tsunamis affected a series of the state coastal towns, with over 130 dying due to the floods. One silver lining was the seismic activity occurred during Good Friday, meaning that all schools and businesses had the day off. Some see this as an act of God's mercy, considering a large amount of the schools collapsed and would have killed hundreds of children who had been there. However, not everyone was as lucky. The enormous tidal waves that followed the tremors completely destroyed and washed away the small village of Chinega, killing close to a half of its population. So from all this information we've gathered in this video, it's sad to say that an earthquake with a magnitude of 9.2 would be one of the most terrifying experiences anyone could ever encounter. While we often express gratitude towards Mother Nature for all she blesses the earth with, we shouldn't forget that at any moment, her creative power could switch to one of annihilation. And this is the end of our video. Did you know that such powerful events could rip through our cities around the world, or that a magnitude earthquake of over 9 has decimated both Chile and Alaska? Let us know what you think about today's video in the comment section below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.